Yo people, I'm TR Mark, I'm here today with Crusader Kings 3. So this is a new series that I'm going to be doing on this channel. This is also a new game which came out in the 1st of September, and it's now the 7th, so it's like a week ago that it came out. I don't know what this game is about. Well, I know that it is set in the medieval style, medieval time of Earth. And yeah, I just know that it is... well, different than Hearts of Iron 4, of course. But, yeah, I'm going to do a new game. I'm not going to do a multiplayer just yet. Maybe later, I don't know. But, yeah, I don't really know much about this game. But we will learn as we go, I guess. So, okay, let's see. Crusader Kings 3 is a deep strategy game of dynasties and intrigue. If you are new to the world of Crusader Kings, we strongly recommend you play the tutorial. Well, we will do that. The tutorial will you will play as Petty King Murchard, a ruler in Ireland. Use your family and dynasty to defeat your enemies and become King of Ireland. Okay, so this is the guy that I'm going to be playing as, I guess. In the game as Petty King Murchard, yes, play the tutorial. Because that's what we want. Army commander is a character in command of an army. Any of your courtiers or direct vassals? Oh, never mind. You're a medieval ruler. Land is yours for the taking. Throw craven marriages and diplomacy or by way of the sword. There is no one way to win in Crusader Kings. Only different ways to enjoy the story that unfolds. Yep. Next. Use the way of the... to move the camera across the map. Also move the cursor to the edge of the... okay. So, like this. The same... okay, let me use WSD. Scroll wheel. Different information is displayed at the different zoom levels. Tail map, political map, and paper map. So I guess the farther I'm out... yeah, this is the paper map. So as you can see, it's a pretty big map. It's of course Europe, Asia, and the northern part of... the Africans, but not United States, because of course to Europeans that was not discovered at that time, except for the Vikings, and that's also a possible outcome that we might be able to play as. But I'm more thinking about playing later as a faction, or at least as the Netherlands, for example, because I am from the Netherlands, of course. So that's that. You have the ability to select and manage your holdings. Zooming out. Okay, so I'm one of these. I guess I'm this. I guess I'm this state. So we have a state to the south, Desmond. So I have Dublin here. We have Ossory. We have Leinster, Athlone, Connacht, Bosnia, Oriel, Alec, and Ulster. And of course, we also have the Isle of Man here. Okay, let's see next. Crusader Kings spans over hundreds of years and many generations. Right now, time is standing still because the game is paused. Okay, so here's the time of the screen. This part will keep the game paused while we walk you through some game concepts. Okay, next. You will see blue highlighted text like this. This means you can hover your cursor over the words for more information. Okay, duchy can lead to county, which can lead to barony. Place your cursor over this highlighted text. Okay, hover over the highlighted phrase inside the highlighted text tooltip. So you mean... okay, neat. Good job. Nice. So this highlighted text in inside highlighted text. Okay, sure. What now? Okay, this is the part that might be difficult because there's so much on screen. It's Catholic, Irish, of course. Player. Okay. Now let's talk about the game. Everything takes place on the map before you. The world consists of large and small pieces of land, each belonging to someone based on their titles. title are represented by icons which elaborate coats of arms. Okay. Set by your primary title, which is the most important and prestigious title you hold, which is the, yeah, this one. The title is the holder, the Petty Kingdom of Munster. It will also have some kind of, what's it? I don't know. We have two provinces, but this is, oh, we also have, do we have ownership of the Desmond? Because the border says it doesn't. Maybe we'll get to that. If you click your character portrait. Yeah, we have these under our control. Part of your realm will light up. Outside of that will be the borders of your entire realm. Munster is your primary title. Which is why your realm is named after it. You'll hold the Earldom of Tomond as a separate title. Ah, so we have both titles, and we also have a claim on the whole of Ireland. Of course, that's true, because we want to unify Ireland, for example. Ruling over others. As a ruler, you can only hold so much land on your own. You will often have other rulers helping with the administration of the realm by holding the land. Titles within your borders make them your vassals. So, yeah, Ormond is your... is our vessel, I guess. Fight your land, your domain. Press the home key and zoom in. This is our little city. Lymnich. We have a city here. We also have the barony of Ferjafjord. I understand. You're playing as one of the other many characters in this world. Your character is the ruler of our realm. The dynasty survives and thrives throughout the ages. Gives you power and control of the territory. Click on your character. Have skills. Some are great at talkers, while others prefer to make their intent clear on the battlefield. Diplomacy, martial stewardship, intrigue, and learning. Okay. Also have traits which can affect skills. You are temperate, so I have a stewardship of +2 and a health. Also small boost of a rifle. -1 diplomacy. Okay, but martial +3. And impatient. Mostly prestige is +20%. Leech -5. Vassal opinion -5. Okay. Also impact how other characters react to you. Are impressed by the brave trait. Well, a lustful character is more likely to feature in salacious gossip. Yes, all have an opinion of one another, which drives their behavior. So I've so my son Brian has a 47 opinion of me. Okay. The further you go, you will need gold, among other things. Gold pays for buildings, armies, and bribes. Gold is collected passively from both your holdings and your vessels as tax. Okay. Larger vessels and more important holdings tend to give more tax. That's true. However, money is not all. Certain things will only be achieved by spending the right amount of prestige or for religious mark, pity. It can be earned over time. Whatever you you earn prestige, okay. Just going to read over them. Love, pity, you will also have an easier time interacting with your head of faith. If you are Catholic, this is the Pope. Oh yeah. From, okay. Level of devotion. I understand. As well as traits, your character can also pick a lifestyle. 5 lifestyles, 1 for each skill. Okay. So this is diplomacy, martial stewardship, stewardship, intrigue, and learning. So it can Check the focuses. Choose a focus. Let me check. I want something with martial. Luck can win a duel. A fool can win a battle. It takes more to win a war. To rule is to make all the aspects of a realm more in unison and work together. Comes through not through brute or gold but honor. I guess the authority. Select. Okay, I understand. Can move on to other people. If you know this game, it's key, and you have many options to how to do so. Character view. Right click. Try to use and confirm the send gift interaction with your heir. Send gift. Who accept? Send gift. Well done, you've successfully increased somebody's opinion of you. Yes, okay. Next, let's talk about your dynasty. This game goes on unless your character meets with a timely accident or a terrible disease, they will grow old and eventually die. It's only game over if you do not have an heir of your own dynasty. Okay, so only if I have an heir, then I will be able to still keep playing. Okay. From the heirs of your dynasty, your legacy will live on. The player heir, yes. So, after Murshot dies, I will possibly be playing as Brian. You are okay. How's Brian? Succession law determines how all titles and resources are divided between the heirs and when a character dies. Only have one heir, but let's take a look anyway. Open the realm view on the right side screen. Okay, this realm. Okay, to the session. Also have Reno. Okay. Level Splendor is the dynasty head, the most mobile. Okay. I understand. You need family members, it helps if you are married, but we cannot promise that you will marry for love. Click on your character. Right click on your own. Find spouse. Oh, I can even filter which one would choose, okay. Get married. Select a spouse for your character and click send proposal. Maybe I should do it with one that has a high opinion of me. Of course, there's a lot. No, I'm not going to do that with kids. Of Leon. Okay. Send proposal. Okay, that's easy. It's important. Okay. Next. Not everyone in your dynasty will be landowners, but every plot of land on the map has an owner. Sometimes that owner is you, sometimes it's one of your vessels, and sometimes it's another realm entirely. Okay, so yeah, this episode might just be the tutorial as a whole. A structure together in a pyramid-like fashion, using title tier. County making you a count of counter or countess. Duchy making you a duke or duchess. Kingdom making you a king or queen, and empire making you an emperor or an empress. that's how it works. So first, Empire, Kingdom, Duchy, County, and Barony.
Okay.
We say technically because as Crusader King lets you play with history, there's no way to guarantee that a king is actually in charge of all the titles that his kingdom is supposed to contain within its borders. Change to the Duchy titles map mode, which is here. Okay. I understand. The year, the title of the minister consists with, of three counties. Term one held by you, held by your neighboring ruler, and Ormon held by your vassal. So, I already need Desmond if I want to have the complete title. Okay, and order the construction of a building, okay. Lookout towers, high tents. Oh, this is even in depth that I would have ever thought. Cattle lands. Cattle lands, maybe. Upgrade. 3 years, Jesus. Hold on. Was it built in a day? No shit. Okay, so the taxes are 2.17. So it might be per day. What a world feel highlighted. Okay, so this is my vassal. Your chancellor and vassal. It's worthwhile keeping your vassals happy. That's true. So I have a chancellor and a vassal, but which vassal is it? Of Inis. Where's Inis? Maybe it's OC? I don't know. No idea. We will see. We will find out. Vessel limit is 20. Ah. If you go beyond this, it will affect the taxes and levies. Okay, I understand. Managing a realm is a lot of work. Open the intrigue view. Okay. Sway. Improving his opinion of you, yes. Open the intrigue view. Okay. Hooks you hold. Oh. Ah, okay, I understand. War is an essential part of Crusader Kings. There are a lot of concepts to cover, but for now, let's touch briefly on some of them. Okay. Most of your soldiers will come from levies, which you can expand your army by employing men at arms. Military view. We'll be able to raise your armies from this green field. Raise all armies button. Star Wars, you'll okay. Almost there. Okay. Soon we'll let you unpause the game. There are just a few things to go first. Oh yeah, the buttons, how fast things will go. But now, as a first test, let's remind your neighbor who is rightful leech truly is. If it happens to expand your realm, so be it. Using the character interaction system that we went over earlier and second time through the map, Jawar on the rule of Desmond. You should already have a valid casus belli as a style is the year a part of your realm. Declare the war, okay. So let me check. How do I declare the war? This is not the right person. There we go. No. Okay. Where do I declare a war? Interaction system when we went over earlier and select them via the map, declare war on the ruler.
Where does it say declare war? Just my question.
Do I do it here? I don't know. Where do I have to go? Yeah, that's great and all, but where is the fucking declare war? Oh, here. Declare war. Declare war. Okay. Successfully declare war. Next, you should rally your armies. Okay, so raise my army. Move your army left, click on the map. And right click on the area you want to go to, perhaps the enemy capital, Barony. Let them go. It's moving. Okay. Okay, there's an enemy army. Okay, 75. Okay. A battle. A siege. Your army is attacking an enemy holding spirits. Okay. Okay. Oh, that's the war score. Okay. I'm really confused by all of this. I guess we just have to do this. Oh yeah, the siege is happening right now. Get the train pregnant, okay. Victory is near. Okay. Enforce demands. Okay, so now I... So be it. Became a vassal of you. 400 prestige based on the contribution. I spent 40 prestige. Gained 40 fame. I understand. What now? Crusader Kings is about setting your own goals. If you want a suggestion, we recommend you try to become the King of Green of Ireland. Yeah, that's what I will do. Okay, disband the army for now. Okay, military. Men and arms. Like footmen, bowmen, high light horsemen, pikemen, armed footmen. Okay, some. Yeah, I guess some catapults. That might be one. Yeah, one bowman. And maybe some light footmen, like horsemen, and maybe pikemen.
I don't know, I'm just choosing stuff.
Okay, so anyways, this is the tutorial that I'm doing today. So in the next episode, I will try to conquer all of Ireland, possibly. Hopefully that will go well, I don't know. But anyways, please like, subscribe to the channel, and see you next video. Bye!